wrapped up in edition of What's on Tap. A lot of phone calls today.
A lot of phone calls.
Absolutely.
Busy show.
Busy show, yes. I think one of the highlights was having Tara come on from San Francisco.
Tara's always a highlight, especially when she's calling from San Francisco.
Absolutely. So much going on. She just astounded us with all the events that she's doing.
Yeah, she got to do quite... She done more things in 1 week than I've done in my entire beer career.
It feels
two
like
days,
it.
Doesn't it? It's amazing. She has an incredible amount of things she's done that would be on a bucket list for somebody like me, and she's doing them all in a week.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Right. Herlinda Harris is a good friend, was on as well. Herlinda lives right in the area where all those fires took place in Sonoma County, or Valley.
Sonoma Valley.
Yeah, exactly. And she recovered. Thank God her house was saved.
Yeah, and she told us, the story that she told us that, she left and she didn't know if her house was going to be there next morning.
Right.
It's pretty harrowing. And they said over 1,000 houses were lost.
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah, it's amazing. And kind of picked and choose where they were going to go. And
I would watch her posts online and thinking to myself, this is playing out like a bad movie. How is this going to work for her?
Yeah, and if you follow Tara or follow Herlinda, you can see, the genesis of where it was and, and what's happened, how the community's come together. Mm-hmm. I mean, they've really done a good job about not letting people forget about it.
True.
And still, we heard today that they auctioned off the number one younger
correct,
over there, Russian River, and so they're still rebuilding. So.
In terms of what we did on the show, we kind of moved away from beer a little bit.
Yeah,
for
we
one
did.
Episode.
We did. We're out of our comfort zone a little
exactly,
bit.
Exactly, yeah. I'm looking forward to getting back into the beer next week, which we will be doing. And we had some Prosecco with an addition that was called Champagne Shots.
Yeah, it was interesting. Little airplane bottles we had to try, and it was very interesting. It added a different flavor profile to Prosecco or champagne.
Absolutely.
And it was different. It was neat.
Then we got to talk to Meredith Megan Williams from Alchemist Society.
I believe it is.
Yeah, in Philadelphia. There's something brand new. It's on North Front Street. And they're putting on some really remarkable educational programs.
Yeah, they're pretty impressive. I mean, they have something that will hit on just about everybody's interest. I mean,
correct.
I like that they are women, and I think that that's a good thing that we need this kind of thing. They do a really, really good job, but they're good for everybody. You know, she's a real good beer personality. I mean, she's a Cicerone certified, one of the 1,300.
Not too many.
Yeah, she really knows her stuff. But
that's amazing.
Doing some really good stuff to promote beer, alcohol, and chocolate, and a bunch of different stuff in the area.
Anytime you get into education, when you teach people about something, I'm on board with that.
Yeah, I think it's great. Learn something, and then you can teach others about it.
Correct. Now, next week on What's on Tap, we have coming up, we're going to do some Sly Fox beers.
Great guys.
We have a rep from Sly Fox coming in. We have a rep from Cape May Brewery coming in. Talk about some of their brand new things coming down.
Back to the beer, and there's lots of things going on in Cape May. Every day I'm getting a press release, something new.
Amazing.
And they're doing a ton. It'd be interesting to see the genesis of a lot of this.
Correct. Now, What's on Tap? Where can you watch this show, the episode that we just completed? Well, you can see it on there, or listen to it. Still used to do it TV. Yeah. Listen to it on demand at SoundCloud.com. Just find us, What's on Tap. This will be our fourth episode that we've put online.
Yeah, and it's nice because Saturday sometimes is a little hard for people to get to. You got
correct,
stuff to do. Mm-hmm. I get a lot of people like, oh, what's that link again? Put it up on our website, Facebook. You can hear everything. And it's very interesting to me of how that's changed.
And let's talk about your podcast as well.
Yeah. We have the South Jersey Beer Scene podcast that I do with my friend Rob Talley, who's also a Jersey Beer Guys and a Girl podcast. That we just released our third episode. We have two more in the can, as they say in the business.
Show business our lives.
Yeah, that's what
right?
I do. They'll be out. Look for us on sjbeerscene.com, SoundCloud, TuneIn Radio, iTunes. We're on all the platforms. And it's been fun. We get to talk to local brewers in a different setting other than talking to them over the bar, getting them sitting down, have a few of their beers. And
that's fun, isn't it?
It's such a good time. We have a really good time with it.
Speaking of beer, you thirsty?
Yeah, I am thirsty.
How about we head over to Glasstown?
That sounds like a great idea.
All right. We'll see you next time on What's on Tap.
Cheers.